today's Ask Flyer. And Reverend Peter Nichols' text this morning is warning to the rich oppressors. It's taken from James chapter 5, 1 through 6. Now listen, you rich people, weep and wail because of the misery that is coming on you. Your wealth has rotted, and the moth has eaten your clothes. Your gold and silver are corroded. Their corrosion will testify against you and eat your flesh like fire. You have hoarded wealth in the last days. Look, the wages you failed to pay the workers to your fields are crying out against you. The cries of the harvesters have reached the ears of the Lord Almighty. You have lived on earth in luxury and self-indulgence. You have fattened yourself in the day of slaughter. You have condemned and murdered the innocent one who was not oppressing you. And this is from James chapter 5, 1 through 6. Let's welcome Reverend Peter Nichols. Go right ahead, Reverend Peter.
Good morning to everyone. I want to greet Dr. Paul, Patrick, all the bishops, Bishop Caesar and others, and ministers of the gospel. Reverend Joseph Evelyn and others who are here with us today, all the saints of God, those who believe in the power of prayer, we want to greet you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we thank God for another opportunity that he's afforded us, that we can come together and pray for our nation and for the issues that are facing our nation at this crucial time. And so we look to the Lord because we know that he's a God who not only hears prayer, but he answers prayer. There is power in prayer. And we are praying in faith today and believing that the Lord will break through in this country and cause his power to be manifested among his people in this nation in the name of Jesus. And so we are praying today specifically for the economy, the economic situation of our country. We know how dire that is right now. People have lost jobs. People are losing homes, losing apartments. People are hungry. The food lines are very long. There is so much turmoil economically. But we're believing the Lord in the name of Jesus to break through and cause this situation. Or our nation is in so much debt. Who would believe that? We owe so much money to our creditors. So we need a breakthrough from God, and we're believing God today in the name of Jesus to do that. So this morning, let me just open in prayer, and then the prayer team will take over. Father, we thank you again that you give us another opportunity to come and to worship you and to praise you and also to lift up the name of Jesus. Also, Father, to bring our requests before you on behalf of our nation. This is, Lord, scriptural. This is biblical. You told us to do this, Father God. You said, blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. And so in the name of Jesus, as we pray today, we thank you that your ears are open unto our cry. We know, Lord, that you will hear us and you will answer us. And a change will come because we pray in faith, believing in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. So we thank you and we praise you, O God, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Yes, Father, who is unto you, Lord? Nobody. We bless you, God, and we praise your name. We glorify you, Lord, and we sing your praises, for you have made us strong. Dear God, as we have reached this penultimate day of our 40-day fast, we come to place before you, Lord, the condition of our nation's economy, with special reference, Lord, to equity and fair distribution. Father, we are seeking your guidance and direction this morning on how we must go about repairing this economy. Fires, God, hurricanes and floodings have completely obliterated people's homes and possessions. The consequences of COVID, Lord, have been catastrophic. It has taken so many hundreds and thousands of lives, God, and counting. Children, Lord, grandparents, who are pillars of support for their grandbabies due to the absence of their parents, loved ones, livelihoods, businesses, savings are all gone. Treasuries are empty this morning, God. Cash boxes are empty, Lord. Dining tables are empty, Lord. People are unable to pay their rent, God. Mortgages, utility, and other essential bills. The education system, Lord, has been shattered. There has been so much pain, confusion, distress and despair. Father, we see that the world has changed. This is a new day, God, a new season, Father. Former things have passed away, Lord. There's no going back, God. There's no business as usual, Father. Heavenly Father, we realize that as seasons change, so do our behavior and activity. And this season of change, Lord, brought about by COVID-19, demands a change in behavior and activity at all levels across the governing body of this nation. There must be new laws, God, new strategies, new methods of leadership, new systems of operation. There must be a completely new outlook and a new vision. God, we need wisdom this morning. Father, we realize that the wisdom that is necessary for rebuilding this country goes beyond the common wisdom of man. It requires, Lord, the wisdom that only you can give. Father, we need you to place into our leaders your wisdom, your thoughts, your counsel, your guidance, without which, Lord, it will be impossible for them to accomplish the task. We ask you, God, to choose the leaders of this nation going forward. Place them strategically where you need them, God, to do exactly as you bid them. Men and women who will not seek to please man, who can only destroy their bodies, but would seek to please you, who can destroy both body and soul. Men and women who will not become weary in well-doing, but will endure, knowing that in due season, they would reap the reward if they faint not. This nation, God, has been called the United States. But in this season especially, dear God, there seems to be nothing united about them. For we can see division everywhere, Father. So we pray, God, for the spirit of harmony to descend upon this nation even now, God. Close the gaps that divide them, God. And grant that they may learn, God, to agree, to disagree without hurting each other by word or deed. Dear God, the leaders of this land have forgotten the oaths that they took and the promises that they made. As they assume their respective offices, they have forgotten the Bible, your word upon which they laid their hands, swearing to you as a witness and uttering the words, so help me, God. They have acknowledged, Lord, that it would be impossible, an impossible task without you, yet they soon turn their backs. Therefore, they have failed to do what is well-pleasing in your sight. The Pledge of Allegiance concludes with the words, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. The anthem says, the land of the free and the home of the brave. The Declaration of Independence said, we hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal and are endowed by their creator with certain inalienable rights. And written on the money, it reads, in God we trust. It is clear, Lord, then, that they had recognized that they needed you, that without you, they couldn't do it. But yet, God, they cast you out of all their ways. And because they have cast you out, God, their true hearts became exposed, our hearts of deceit and wickedness. Jeremiah 17:19 states, the heart of man is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who can know it? But dear God, today we declare that you and you alone know the heart of man. Psalms 44:21 tells us that you know the secrets of our hearts, God. 1 Samuel 16:7 says, man looks at the outward appearance, but God, you look at our hearts. Romans 8:27 says, he that searches the hearts knows what is in the mind of the spirit. So, Father, today we pray that the hearts of those who lead this country, all over, everywhere, leaders across the country, everywhere, across this nation also, who have turned their hearts away from your promises, from their promises to you, will be reconciled in Jesus' name. Father, we ask you to turn their hearts away from seeking after their own ungodly pleasures and desires, from greed, unselfishness, unrighteousness, lust, deceit, absence of of love, lack of compassion, and a love for money. Deliver them, Lord, all from all forms of carnality, God. 1 Timothy 6:10 states that the love of money is the root of all evil, which while some coveted there, which while some coveted after, they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. America has boast of being the richest and most powerful nation on earth. Maybe because of its weapons of war and its military power, but all at the same time, God, due to their unfair and unequal practices and treatment of their citizens, we have seen abject poverty and great affluence living side by side. Heavenly Father, I pray that the future of America will boast of being the richest and most powerful nation on this earth, not because of weapons of war or of military power, but because its leaders have allowed God to be their only source of strength, to rule and reign in their hearts, to follow God's wisdom that will teach them how to transform this nation from a place where the system of governance encourages the bulk of its wealth to be squarely rested in the hands of a few, to a country where all people are seen as equal, to a place where there is equity and fair distribution, where no child goes to bed hungry at night, where no man, woman, boy, or girl freezes to death during the winter, rather be on the streets or in their homes just because they cannot afford basic necessities. Let America boast of a healthcare system that provides affordable care for the elderly, the mentally ill, the veterans who have served and sacrificed their lives, health, and families to protect this country and return to civilian life with post-traumatic stress, where the poor and the needy, the widows and the orphans are cared for as your word instructs, where men and women who are released from prison are reacclimated into the society as human beings, where wage-earning opportunities are available to them. Those who have had 30 years of their life stolen away from them willfully and wrongfully will be recompensed. An America where the education system is timely and meets the needs of all its children and the demands of the future. Identify leaders, God. Equip them with wisdom and strategies to plan and execute programs that are workable, easy to follow, but productive and relevant. Let the education system seriously take the responsibility of adequately educating our children, realizing that our quality of life in the future strongly rests on the quality of the education that we provide to our youth today. A system where all required personnel will be available, where all children will receive the necessary devices and equipment needed for learning, where up-to-date scientific and technological knowledge will be forthcoming so that the educators will be educated themselves to become sufficiently expert in this advanced technology to enable easier transfer of knowledge, where parents will be trained to be better able to assist their children in this modern way of learning, where now and their future college graduates will be employed in their fields, where citizens can afford a postgraduate education without having to spend the rest of their lives repaying the loan. We pray for a transformed America, God. A transformed America where the super rich will pay their fair share of taxes, where the super rich will give to the poor. For your word says that who hath pity upon the poor lends to God. Proverbs 19:17. We pray that all the riches gained by fraudulent and predatory means will be given back, God. Proverbs 13:11-22 states that wealth gotten by vanity shall be diminished. He that gathereth by labor shall increase. Verse 22 says, the wealth of the sinner is laid up for the righteous. We pray, Lord God, that minimum wage will rise to be comparable with the cost of living, that women, God, will receive equal pay for equal work. Father, in the name of Jesus, we know and we believe that you can and you will make all these things come to pass, God. Lord, because you can do exceeding and abundantly more than we could ask or even imagine. You ask in your word, God, is there anything too hard for me? You are a miracle working God. You are a God of impossibilities. Nothing is too difficult for you. You said that you will pour out of your spirit upon all flesh. So yes, God. Yes, Lord. This morning we give you the thanks and the praise for transformation, reconstruction, restoration, and revival of this economy in this land. Father, we also ask you this morning, God, to show your church what is our role in reviving and restructuring this nation's economic system. You said, Lord, that we are the salt of the earth and the light of the world. And if the salt have lost its savior, wherewith shall it be salted? Matthew 5:13-14. Salt and light, God, are two indispensable commodities on this earth. Their uses are vast and vital. Light eradicates the darkness and shows the way. It makes the vision clear and brings understanding. It guides on a well-lighted pathway. It keeps you focused on God's will and purpose and plan. Among the tens of thousands of uses for salt, salt purifies, seasons, preserves, cures, extends life, tenderizes, makes the taste better. So Heavenly Father, today we offer your salt and your light back to you that you may use us, God. Teach us and show us the way that we might go, teach us and show us the way that we must go. We say, God, that we are willing, Lord, because we can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. And finally, God, we pray that the spirit of humility will continue to increase in our lives, that we will continue to seek your peace, that you will continue to search our hearts, know our thoughts, and remove any wicked way in us. Father, continue to hear our praise. We thank you, God, for you continue to heal us, Father. For we ask this in no other name. Continue, God, to cover this earth with your presence, God. Cover the earth with the sound of heaven, God, as the waters cover the sea. We ask you, God, that you would continue to grant our petitions, for we ask, believing that we receive, in the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Bless God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for praise that have come up before your throne room this morning, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for another opportunity. Come boldly before your throne of grace, Lord God. Thank you that we find grace and help in the time of need. We thank you, Lord God, that we come to the all-wise God, the God who is the creator of heaven and earth, the one who is still in control of everything. Lord God, your word declares in Psalm 97, verse 7, for you, Lord, are high above all the earth. You are exalted far above all gods. Father, I exalt you. I exalt you, Lord God. I exalt you. Glory to God. Praise be to your name. I thank you, Lord God, that we can come running to you at all times. Thank you for your great power and your outstretched arms towards us. Glory to God. Thank you that you never grow weary of your children coming to you. Yes, Lord God, we come to you because you welcome us in the beloved, Jesus Christ, our Savior, our Redeemer, our King of Kings, and our Lord of Lords. Thank you, Jesus, for your precious, powerful blood through which we come. We come in the blood of Jesus. It will never lose its power. The cleansing blood, the healing blood, the delivering blood, the keeping blood, sustaining blood, all the blood of Jesus, it washes us. All the blood of Jesus, it was shed for us. Hallelujah. All the blood of Jesus that saved our lives. Hallelujah. Yes, the blood of Jesus is our victory. We come, Lord God, today and stand, Lord God, of victory in the place, Lord God, standing, Lord God, victorious. Father, we Thank you, Lord God, that you've saved us and you've kept us. Glory to God. And as we come, Lord, we invoke also the presence and power of the Spirit of the living God. We say, come, Holy Spirit, we need you. Come, sweet Spirit, we pray. Come in your strength. Come in your power. Come in your own special way. I thank you, Father, for that presence and power of the Spirit of the living God. Glory to God. Praise God forevermore. Bless God forevermore. Hallelujah. We thank you now that you take the things of the Father and you bring them to us. In the Holy Ghost fire, burn out the dross and the pride, anything that is not of God, so that our prayers come before you, Lord God, as a sweet smelling savor. Pour your Spirit, Lord God. Pour your Spirit. We need you, Lord God. Pour your Spirit upon us. Hallelujah. Forgive us our trespasses and our sins, Lord God, so that our prayers, Lord God, will be answered. And now, Father, we take our rightful place. The word of God says, behold, I give unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the powers of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt us. I bind up every serpent-like spirit, every corporate scorpion spirit over our economy, every spirit that has rigged our economy so that there is misproportions, every spirit that has rigged our economy so that there's inequity, much suffering and lack, unrestrained exploitation of the poor and the needy, those that are not well represented or not represented at all. We bind up those powers of greed and wickedness, particularly those under the guise of Lord not-for-profit organizations, and especially those, Lord God, who are in the government, those who are governing, Lord God, this country. Lord, for too long we have struggled. We have marched, we have knocked on doors of the judicial system. Yet still today, the disparity in our economy is the same. The status, Lord God, is the same as it ever was. I pray, Lord God, that we, Lord God, who are still in the race, Lord God, will join in, Lord God, with the younger generations so that we, Lord God, have a good understanding of who we are, first of all, in Christ. We are heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ Jesus. We are the seed of Abraham and have the blessings of health, the blessings of wealth, and a spiritual legacy. We are blessed, Lord God, to be a blessing. Therefore, let us understand our value. Let us understand our worth. We must not sell ourselves short. May we understand clearly that we are defined by our worth. How we see ourselves have a major impact on how the others see us, how others will see us. May we know our true worth, Lord God. Father, you have made us a kingdom of priests unto you. God, you have given us abilities to assess ourselves. We must walk in that knowledge, Lord God. Let us be bold in our demands. Let us pray and work and speak up. Let us have an awareness of our worth and see to it, Lord God, that we get what we rightfully deserve. May we align ourselves with those who have paved the way before us, those who have, Lord, come alongside of us to help us. Father, our economy is a mess. We need your help. So we cry out to you. For too long we have suffered. For too long the wealth has been manipulated into the hands of a few. For too long we have grimaced and borne and struggled to survive. We come asking for mercy, for grace, for wisdom, Lord God. We want to take back all that the enemy has stolen from us. We seek your favor, Lord God, your justice, Father. We need a word from you. Father, you are the restorer. Father, you see the hearts of men. You understand our thoughts even afar off. Nothing is impossible with you, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God, that our economy can be turned around and will be turned around, Lord God, as we continue to band forces, as we continue to work together. We dismiss all doubt and unbelief, Lord God. We embrace your spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of who you are, who owns everything, Lord God. May our eyes be opened. May we, Lord God, allow our eyes to be enlightened. Lord, you have called us not to poverty, but to riches, to your inheritance which you have deposited in us. May we better understand our role, Lord God, not only in the church, but also in the society. May we contribute to our economic state. May we help gain a fair share in the distribution of the wealth by pursuing, Lord, the right people whom you have put in place, Lord God, to help us. Father, you have made us to have dominion over the earth. We, Lord, have been ravaged over time. We have lost our first estate, but you, O Lord, is the restorer. Even as we have reached this 39th day of our 40-day prayer and fasting for our nation, Lord God, you have been restoring. You have, Lord, heard our praise. You have, Lord, answered our praise. And we thank you, Lord God. We know you will continue to do so. The word of God reminds us in 1 Corinthians 3:7 that one plant and another water God, you give the increase. Father, bring to bear the blood, the sweat and the tears of our fathers, the contributions we have made throughout the years of this nation. Turn around the misuse and the abuse of our labor. Bestow upon us, Lord God, that which was never given. Pour into us, Lord God, so that we can pour into others and achieve a better livelihood. Grant us wealth that may cause us to excel, Lord God. Will cause us to advance. May we be wise in the allocation of our money, Lord. May we be willing to give of our tithes and our offerings, knowing that we sow, Lord God, who sow that which we sow, we will also reap in the name of Jesus. Help us to be intentional in our giving to you and receive from you that abundance that, you have promised us. Let us not look at the season or the situation, but let us have faith and believe you. Father, thank you for the birthing of good ideas and for fruitfulness, Lord God, for those ideas, Lord God, to be realized. Let them not die, Lord God, but bring us good success. Help us to be led to the right people who will promote our businesses. May we be honest and hardworking, persons of integrity, Lord. May we represent you well. Let us operate by kingdom principles. Romans 12:11 declares not to be slothful in business, but to be fervent in spirit, serving the Lord. May we know that God sees and rewards us accordingly. May our businesses thrive and thrive well because we honor you, Lord. Lord, said in your word, other men labored, and we are entered into their labor. May we too make our mark. May all of us, especially the youthful generation, also make significant contributions. May we be wise to spread the knowledge, the experience, the techniques, the basics of good business practices. May we be willing, Lord God, to share, Lord God, share the older and the younger. May we impact our economy. With God on our side, our working together should stimulate the economy. Like Boaz, Lord, let us allow grain to fall from the bundles purposely, so that others can have, so that others can glean, so that we can work better together to advance, Lord God, the entire, Lord, human race. As we bless others, we are blessed. We experience supernatural increase at the hands of Almighty God. Lord, help us not to be deceived. The Gibeonites were deceived, were deceitful people. They were full of guile and trickery. Having heard of Joshua and his conquest, they made themselves appear to be industrious, be hardworking. They begged to join the Israelite army, offered to become servants of Joshua. Unfortunately, Joshua's men merely looked over the men of the Gibeonites, unaware that they were imposters. They did not, as Lord, you would recommend, ask counsel at your mouth, at your hands, but they made an oath with the Gibeonites. And when Joshua discovered the deception, he made them slaves. The word says he made them hewers of wood and drawers of water. But the damage was already done. The camp was divided, and the Israelites murmured against Joshua. Deceit brought about an ungodly compromise. Lord, may we ever ask of you and hear from you first, so that our businesses will not crash. Will not, Lord God, allow ill-intentioned persons, pretenders, Lord God, to come in amongst us and to divide us and to, Lord God, cause our businesses to fail and to make life even more difficult. May we always seek your guidance, your divine guidance. May we keep in step with Jesus, Lord. Let us seek your counsel. May we know that divine timing is everything. It is your counsel that brings us good success. We understand that our nation is over its head in debt. We have borrowed countless sums of money and are unable to pay it back. We can rest assured any attempts to pay back will have a trickle-down effect. Taxes will increase, food costs, living costs, educational costs. Every sphere of our economy will be affected by these increases. May wisdom prevail, Lord God. May we, Lord God, position ourselves. May we manage our finances well, Lord God. May we, Lord God, realize, Lord God, that even now, in this difficult time, we yet must cut back on our spending. We must yet tighten our belts. Lord, we cannot build any credit card debt. Lord, we will seek ways to save as much as we can while finding additional ways to make money. To reinvest, maybe do so in ways that will return good on our investment in education and skills, Lord God. May we do more to help ourselves and depend less upon the system. May we get ourselves healthy as possible. God is still the healer. Reduce our medical costs. Position ourselves to overcome greater disaster. Receive our instructions now from God and for future preservation. The economic state of America needs to be rebuilt. Only God can help us. For too long, the spirit of greed and hatred has spread itself over the states. We seek you, Lord, so that we can drive them out, so that we can bring restoration. We humble ourselves, Lord God. These 39 days have borne out our efforts to rebuild. Let us drive out those demonic spirits. Let us, Lord, genuinely love and share, Lord God, amongst the believers, all that we have and all that we know. Help us, Lord, to grow the church of Jesus Christ, that we build a culture of well-informed believers, Lord. We invest in our youth so that we don't die. Moses had his Joshua. Jesus had his disciples. We must impact our youth, invest in them, educate them, Lord, motivate them to greater accomplishments, even more so than we have accomplished. Pass on to them a legacy, Lord God, of good work ethics, good training, good business development and practices. Lord, please touch us so that we can touch other lives. We cannot make it without you, Lord. Like Nehemiah, we are grieved, we are burdened, we are distressed. Thank you, Lord, for showing us that you, what you did for Nehemiah, you can do for us, Lord. May we continue to pray, Lord. May we continue to seek your timing. May we know, Lord God, that it cost. May we prepare ourselves, Lord God. May we do, Lord God, what research is necessary. May we know who to speak to and when to speak to those persons, Lord God. You have placed people, Lord God, in our paths. May we recognize them. Know who they are, Lord God. Know, Lord God, those who are genuinely, Lord, working with us and for us. We thank you, Lord, for you are still in control. You have not lost your grip, Lord God, in the United States of America. You know exactly what is happening, Lord. Help us to trust you. Let us work together, Lord. This is our key. Lord, united we stand, divided we fall. I remember my dad saying to me, Sybil, set a goal, have a plan. Father, we must. Help us in all these areas, Lord. When our plans have been rested, we can spread, tested, Lord God, we can spread them. God is always with us. Let us seek his guidance every step of the way. Lord, we thank you that our 39 days have been inspiring. We have been challenged, Lord God. Let us keep on the firing line. Let us keep the spirit of cooperation and togetherness alive. And Father, help us to focus. It is so easy to be distracted. Help us to press in the spirit so that we discipline ourselves and that, Lord, we stay at the task. We are the ones to rebuild this country and the world. Lord, we are the called up ones. You have blessed us, Lord God, with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ. May we fulfill God's divine plan and purposes for the church, Lord God, and in our nation. May we stay connected, Lord. May we keep pressing on until our breakthroughs come. In Jesus' mighty name we pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen. Praise God forevermore. Bless God forevermore. Glory to God forevermore.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Who can be likened unto you, O God? Who can be compared to you, O God? Father God, this morning we say unto you, Lord, there is none that can be likened unto you. There is none that can be compared to you in the name of Jesus. Father God, as we come into your presence this morning, Lord, Father, we take note, dear Lord God, that James 5 also said, O God, be patient and stand firm, for the judge is standing at the door. Is anyone among you in trouble? Let them pray. For the prayer of a righteous person is powerful and effective. Our God and our Father, we enter into your presence this morning, knowing that you, Lord God, you, the judge, O God, is standing and waiting at the door, waiting for your children to call on your name, Lord, waiting for your children to come boldly before your throne. Father God, as we humble ourselves, dear Lord, and heed the call to pray, Father God, we stand on your word this morning. Lord God, we stand, dear Lord God, in the prayer of righteousness, O Lord, knowing, dear Lord God, that the person O God, who prays that righteous prayer, Lord God, that prayer would be powerful this morning, O God, in the name of Jesus, and it will also be effective. Father God, we enter in, Lord God, knowing that you said in Isaiah 44, Lord, that you are the Lord who made us and formed us in the womb, and you are the one who will help us, O God, so we need not be afraid. Father God, as I come this morning into your presence, Lord, I lift up the United States of America. Lord, there
There is nothing, dear God, that is hidden from you. You are aware this morning of all that is taking place in this nation. You know the state of this economy, Lord God. You know what is taking place in the hidden places, oh God, and behind the closed doors. Lord, as I come, dear Lord God, this morning in the name of Jesus, I utter the words of the psalmist David, who said in Psalm 69, I pray to you, Lord, in the time of your favor, oh God, in your great love, oh God, answer me with your sure salvation. Rescue us, oh God, from the mire. Do not let us sink, oh God. Deliver us, oh God. Do not let the flood waters engulf us, or the depth swallow us up, or the pit close its mouth over us. Answer us, oh Lord God, out of the goodness of your love. In your great mercy, Lord, turn to us. Come near, Lord God, and rescue us. Rescue us, dear Lord God, this morning from the hands of the enemy. Father God, we know, Lord, that while the voices of our leaders may be silent regarding the depth of this country, and many citizens may not even be aware, Lord God, of the debt the country owes its debtor, we know, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, that you are attentive, Lord, that you know. Lord, you said in your word, oh God, that the borrower is servant to the lender. You know, Lord God, who our lenders are. You know who the leaders of this country are servants to. Lord, you know, oh God, why things in this country have taken the direction that it has. You know, Lord God, why our leaders are entertaining and associating with the enemy. But this morning, Lord God, as I come before you, I'm asking you for an intervention, Lord. I ask that you would intervene, oh God, and deliver this country from the bondage and the burden of debt in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Break this financial bondage, Lord, because you know, oh God, that the citizens of the country are the ones who carry the burden of this debt, Lord. Give us the ability, oh God, to pay all of our debts. Father God, as citizens of this nation, we are not aware of how this country or why this country is in the position that it is. But we know, Lord God, that you are aware of all the deals that were made, oh God, and who the people are that will be the beneficiaries of these deals. Father God, there are so many things that are hidden from the public. But Lord, we know, oh God, that while they are hidden from man, they are not hidden from you, because you are the all-knowing God. You know all things. You are aware, oh God, of all the handshakes and the signatures that seals the deals. But Father God, this morning I ask that you break those covenants, Lord. Lord, and I command this nation, this mountain of debt, dear Lord God, that the leaders, Lord God, may turn a blind eye to be moved this morning in the name of Jesus. I pray, Lord God, that those who lead in this country in the new year will be excellent stewards of the finances of this country. I pray, Lord God, that the leaders will allow you to lead and direct the financial plans of this country, and that they will not fall into any further financial trap. Father God, this morning in the name of Jesus, I pray, oh God, that the economy will rebound, not because one person says it or try to manipulate things to provoke it, oh God, but that you, Lord God, will prove yourself and cause it to work in the favor of your people. We know, Lord God, that you are fully aware of the reckless behavior that these people who leave our country have brought, Lord God, the chaos, Lord, the recklessness that these people are using, the people that lead our country, you are aware, dear God, of the chaos that they have placed on us, oh God, moving the country, oh God, and the economy from being stable to unstable. But we know, Lord God, this morning that in this instability, Lord God, that you can bring stability. So I ask you, oh Lord God, that you will stabilize our economy. Turn to God, bring about a shift, dear Lord God, in the standards of this country. Remember your people, oh God, this morning in the name of Jesus at this time. Father, we know that you are aware of all that is happening to and among the citizens of this country. You know, Lord God, that we do not experience fair distribution of resources. You know, Lord God, that certain groups of people are not given the same exact resources of others. Father God, you know, Lord God, that even though our race of people has a greater need, oh God, they are not given the equity to meet that need. You know, Lord God, that the distribution of resources, our Lord, is not fair and impartial. You know, Lord God, that there are so many biases when it comes to our Black race. But this morning, oh God, in the name of Jesus, I lift my voice to you, Lord God, and I cry out to you like the Israelites in Egypt, Lord God. We sung the alarm this morning, and we called out there, Lord God, like the psalmist David, oh God. And we say to you this morning, help, Lord, help. Father God, this morning we lift up the inequality in the tax system before you. Father God, you know the one who carries the burden of the taxes. Father God, you know, Lord God, this morning that it is the middle class people who are saddled with this burden. Father God, you see there, Lord God, what the leaders have done. You are aware this morning, oh God, that they have went in, Lord God, and they shifted everything, oh God, giving the corporations, oh God, and those who make the bulk of the money, Lord God, to break from the tax, oh God, and they pass this tax on to us. But this morning, oh God, we look to you and we cry, Lord, because we know, oh God, that you are fully aware, Lord God, of what is happening to your people. You know, Lord God, the things that it is preventing us from doing. So this morning, oh God, we ask that you would intervene. We ask, dear Lord God, that you would remove, Lord God, the burden of this tax system, oh God, and you would pass it back to the corporations and the people, dear Lord God, who have the millions and the billions of the dollars, and you would cause them to pay their fair share in the name of Jesus. Father God, this morning we look at the inequality in the schools, oh God. Father, we know that all of this is set up, dear Lord, because of a system. Father God, this morning we observe and we watch and we notice, oh God, that they're entering into our neighborhoods, oh God. They take our best teachers, Lord, and they send them over to the white neighborhoods to educate the white children. And they send those white teachers, oh God, who are uncaring, and they place them into our neighborhoods this morning, oh Lord God. And these teachers come in, dear Lord God, and they speak down to our children. They speak negative to our children. They tell our children, oh God, that they would end up in prison, that they will not be anything. But this morning, oh Lord God, I am here to reverse that curse in the name of Jesus. I am asking you, Lord God, to break that curse. I am asking you, Lord God, this morning to intervene, oh God, in the system of our education. And I'm asking you, Lord God, in the name of Jesus, for a fair share. Father God, I lift up the inequality in the workforce to you. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I know that you know, Lord God, and I know that you see, Lord God, and I know that you are aware, oh God, that Father God, in the name of Jesus, they do not pay us what we deserve, Lord God. Father God, they set us up, oh God, and we work hard, Lord God, and Father God, then they would bring in the white person and they would set us to train this person, and then they would give the person the job at the top, Lord God, and they would pay the person more than they're paying us. But this morning, oh God, I lift this up to you, for I know that you are well aware, Lord God. You've seen our struggles, Lord God. You've seen all the things that have happened to us, oh God, and we're asking for a turnaround. You know, Lord God, that as women, we are quite able, and sometimes even better able, oh God, than the men, Lord God. But you see, oh God, how we are treated. And you know, Lord God, that we are not given our fair share. But Father God, this morning, in the name of Jesus, we are not losing hope, oh God. We are not losing hope this morning in the name of Jesus. Because we know, oh Lord God, that you are in touch with our infirmities. We know, Lord God, that you are working on our side. And Father God, how could I forget, dear Lord God, the inequality community, in the community setting, in the housing system, in the banking system. Father God, you see there, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. Lord God, they bring their banks and they place them, oh God, into our neighborhoods. Father God, we run there, Lord God, and we deposit our monies into their system. And oh God, we go and we ask for a loan, oh God, and they turn us down. They turn us away, dear Lord God, because they do not want us to be in a position to accomplish. Lord God, they do not want us to be in a position to set up businesses. They do not want us to be in a position, dear God, to buy homes. Lord God, our certain homes, dear Lord God, with certain prices. But Father God, this morning we're asking you for a turnaround, Lord God. We're asking you, oh God, this morning in the name of Jesus, that you will turn things around. Father God, we're asking, oh God, that you would give us the ability to own. Father God, we're asking that you would give us that ability, oh dear Lord God, in the name of Jesus, to set up our businesses, oh God. Lord God, and to set up our own banks, dear Lord God, so that we can help our own people, oh God, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus. Morning, Lord God, I ask in the name of Jesus that you will destroy every financial curse, dear Lord God, every financial setback for your people in the name of Jesus. Lord, I ask that you have already given us the power this morning to get well, Lord God. And I ask this morning in the name of Jesus that you will direct our steps, oh Lord God, and you will help us to operate in that God-given power this morning. In the mighty name of Jesus, Lord God, let your anointing to get well rest upon our lives this morning in the name of Jesus. Father God, show us how to be strategic in our doings. Father God, we realize, dear Lord God, that when Haman, dear Lord God, set out, dear Lord God, to kill the Jews, we went to Esther, dear Lord God. And Father God, we see how Esther was strategic. Esther just said, oh God, to the people, prayer. Let us go in for a time of prayer and fast, oh God. And they entered in, Lord God. And at the time, oh God, when it came for her to execute, Lord God, she did not, dear Lord God, perform the battle in public. But she moved it, oh God, from public into the private place with just the king, oh God, and Haman. And Father God, we saw, Lord God, how her strategy prevailed, oh God, and how, dear Lord God, all that Haman had set up had turned around on him. So we're asking you this morning in the name of Jesus to help us, oh Lord God, to be strategic like Esther this morning in the name of Jesus. Father God, we're asking you to impart wisdom, dear Lord God, to us, Lord, and show us, dear God, the strategies to use to relieve ourselves from these financial burdens. Help us, Lord, not to walk in the counsel of the ungodly this morning. Let us prosper financially, oh God, and give us the grace to walk in this prosperity. Father God, this morning in the name of Jesus, I ask that you will let us take back what the enemy has stolen from us in the name of Jesus. Father God, let us take back what the enemy has stolen from us this morning, oh Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I confess by faith this morning, oh God, that we will partake in the wealth of the wicked, which shall be transferred to the believers in the name of Jesus. Father God, we will not be afraid this morning. We will not run away and hide at this time, dear Lord God, of the pandemic. Father God, we will not be afraid of the turn of the economy, oh God, because we know this morning, oh God, that you are on our side and you are standing with us. We know this morning, oh Lord God, that you will fight for us. So Father God, we will stand like Jehoshaphat this morning, and we will say to you, Lord, the Lord God, our ancestors, are you not the God who is in heaven? Father God, this morning you rule over all the kingdoms of the nation. Power and might are in your hand, oh God, and no one can withstand you this morning. Father God, we will stand this morning and wait, Lord God, We will wait for you, oh Lord God, to confuse the enemy and turn them against themselves this morning. We will wait for your direction, oh God. We will wait for your direction, God. We will wait, oh Lord God, to go in and carry off the plunder this morning. And Lord God, after all of this is finished, oh God, we will not forget this morning, oh Lord God, to give you the praise. We will not forget this morning, oh Lord God, to give you the honor. We will not forget this morning, oh Lord God, to give you the glory for all that you have done. Father God, we will give you thanks, oh Lord God, for turning our situation around and for making us the head this morning and not the tail, for placing us above this morning and no longer beneath, for freeing us, oh God, from the bondage of indebtedness, for giving us breakthrough in all aspects of our needs this morning. Father God, we will thank you, Lord, for causing us to prosper in all that we set ourselves to do, for teaching us, oh God, how to tap into the system, dear Lord God. For Father God, this is not the end, Lord God. We will unite this morning, oh God, knowing that in unity we will stand, and knowing that in unity, oh Lord God, we will accomplish great success. And most of all, oh Lord God, this morning, in the name of Jesus, we will thank you, oh Lord God. We will thank you, oh Lord God, for being our God. We will thank you, Lord, for being our help in this time of need. Father God, this morning, in the name of Jesus, I give you, oh Lord God, all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory that is due unto your most high, holy, and precious name. In Jesus' name, I pray with thanksgiving. Amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Jeremiah 32 said, O Lord God, thou hast made the heavens and the earth by your great power and outstretched arm. Nothing is too difficult for thee. Lord, we declare that nothing is too difficult for you. With your outstretched arm, God, you have done wonders. And God, as we stand and we thank you for all the praise that have been ascended to the throne, we know that you hear us. We have this confidence that you will give us the petitions of what we ask for. And Lord, we pray for our economy. You said in your word that money answereth all things. So God, we bring the stock market before you, God. Father, we speak life into the stock market so people and companies can invest, so they can provide capital to companies and they can use this fund for expanding their businesses, that many, oh God, will be employed in the name of Jesus Christ. God, there are many, oh God, are unemployed, but God, we're asking for your blessings. As we speak life, you tell us that death and life lies in the power of the tongue, God. So on the authority of your word, we speak life to the stock market in the name of Jesus Christ. And God, we speak to the employers that rob, oh God, employees of their wages. God, it reminds us of the taxpayers of old. But God, I declare this morning, God, as Zacchaeus said, half of my goods I give to the poor. And if I accept anything falsely, Lord, I restore fourfold. And God, in the name of Jesus, we break this cycle in Jesus' name. And we call forth our wages, God, that have been stolen from us. We expect it, God. We look forward for it, God. We look forward for our bonuses in the name of Jesus, that we can provide for our families, God, in the name of Jesus Christ. We give you praise. You tell us, oh God, that the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the righteous. And God, you tell us to ask, and we ask for it this morning in the name of Jesus, according to your word. We pry it out their hands in the name of Jesus. We speak and we say we want it. We speak and we say we give it up in the name of Jesus Christ. God, we know that you will send a deliverer. Lord, we know you will raise up the right right man in this time of election. A man, oh God, with a wisdom like Joseph. Oh God, when the famine was coming, you give him wisdom that God, he prepared. He knew what to do. That in the time of famine, they had enough for their country and for countries that need food. I pray, God, in the name of Jesus, that in this election, God, you will handpick the man you want for these next 4 years, that will bring America back to where it was. In the name of Jesus, we curse every spirit, every word that have been said against our nation, God, in the name of Jesus. But I pray, Holy Ghost, that your power, your Spirit will speak to the leaders of this nation and bring them to their knees, soften their hearts, that it will be a turnaround. It will be a call of God, God, in the name of Jesus, that our president and the members of Congress and Senate, God, will call upon the church, will call upon the leaders, the one that's full with the Holy Ghost, the one that have a right word from the throne room to speak to the president and tell him what to do. God, take us back to the times when the leaders will call upon the men of God for direction, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for the homeless. And God, we pray, God, that you will move. You will make a way for them. Oh, God, we speak, God, against foreclosures. God, that people will retain their homes in the name of Jesus. God, we speak to the farmers. We speak to the ground that it will give forth its fruit in this season. We call the rain upon the earth in the name of Jesus Christ. And God, we thank you for all you're going to do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise Amen. The Lord. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Father.
We give God thanks. We thank you, Reverend Peter and the team from New Creation International Church there in Canarsie, Brooklyn. We thank God for all of our hosts and your team members for joining us. You've come to a critical crossroad in our season of prayer and fasting. May we have done all that we can do. Hallelujah. God, hallelujah. God does the rest.
Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
That's the kind of God that we serve. Glory to God. So I encourage you to continue to trust the Lord. Let's go the last stretch of this journey. Paul said, I've run the race. Hallelujah. I've finished my course. Amen. Oh, glory to God. Now the rewards are coming. Tomorrow we're coming together for our final day of our time of prayer together, but it won't be our final day together. We'll be giving God thanks for all the things that we have been petitioning him for. We're thanking him in advance and what he's going to do for us in the future. The Lord bless you. The Lord watch over you. The Lord keep you. The Lord strengthen you. And again, thank you so very much, Reverend Peter Nichols, and all the members of your team. We have been edified once again today. God bless you. God bless you.